Good morning, my little brothers and sisters in Christ. I hope you're having a great day. Today we're going to hear a little bit about a boy named Samuel who God directed in life. And Samuel followed his directions. So here's a little word from God from our reading for today. God called Samuel. He appeared to him and called him to come into service. So here is from 1 Samuel 3, verse 10. And the Lord came and stood, calling as at other times, Samuel, Samuel. And Samuel said, Speak, Lord, for your servant listens or hears. And then a little further later in verse 19 and 20, and Samuel grew, and the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. That meant that everything that Samuel said and told the people was true, and God was always with him. And then verse 20, and all Israel, from the land of Dan to the land of Beersheba, knew that Samuel was established as a prophet of the Lord. That means that they recognize that Samuel was a special prophet that was sent from God. And so they needed to listen to him. Okay, I got a question for you. Do you know what this is? This is a compass, and it gives you direction. It always points to the north, and if you are lost, if you have a compass, then you can find your way out. As long as you have a compass, then you can find your way out. And then it can take you through, and you can know where you're going and things along that line. Well, Samuel was a young lad in our reading for today, and Samuel was a special person. Well, everybody's special. You're special too, because God don't make no junk. But in Samuel's life, his mom couldn't have any babies. And she prayed and prayed and prayed in the church called the temple. And finally God said, okay, I will let you have a baby. And the baby's name was Samuel. And Elkanah, which is his dad, and Hannah, his mom, said, wow, this is great stuff. So we're going to give our little baby, Samuel, over to work for God in the temple. And so as he grew up, Samuel was living in the temple with a guy named Eli, and Eli was sort of his mentor. But then one night, God came calling to Eli and said, or excuse me, to Samuel and said, Samuel, Samuel, I've got something different for you to do. And Samuel said, okay, speak, Lord, for your servant hears. And God told him what he was going to do. God changed his direction in life. Samuel and his parents thought that he was going to be serving in the temple all his life, but God said, nope, I'm going to take you on a different direction. You're going to be a prophet. You're going to serve me in a special way to tell other people about me and that I'm the only way for salvation. I'm the only one for hope. And when things look dark and dreary, you still follow me. I know the way. And Samuel did that. And as he grew on, God also said another direction. He said, now, Samuel, I want you to anoint a king. That means I've got somebody special in mind to be a king over my people. There's another king out there that isn't really the one that I want. So I want you to go and anoint one. And this is who I want you to do. Well, as Samuel grew older, he was older, and then God said, here's the one. His name is a shepherd boy, and his name is David. Now, maybe you know about David with David and Goliath and how David was a shepherd boy and things like that, but God had a special plan for David as well. And God said to Samuel, Samuel, I need you to anoint or select this guy, David. He might be the smallest of all of them, but I'm going to use him in a great way. And that's what God did, because as David grew older and he became a king and he was sitting on the throne, God came to David and said, David, I'm going to make a promise to you that from your family all the way down, we're going to have a savior who's going to come. And David said, well, I'm going to believe you, God, because you made that promise to me. But that promise took 950 years to be kept. But God always keeps his word. And we hear about that in Luke chapter 2, the Christmas story, verses 10 to 12. The angel said to the shepherds, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." See, God always keeps his word. And our life, we don't know what the future will hold. We don't even know what tomorrow will bring. But God does. And he always says, "Follow my direction." And so we do. The Christian always follows God through his word and through his sacraments. We listen to Jesus, and Jesus is your compass. So always follow him. "Speak, Lord, for your servant listens." And Jesus is the one who changed our direction. Jesus changed our direction forever and ever and ever. We were supposed to, because we disobeyed, spend eternity in hell. And God said, "No, I don't want to do that. I got to change their direction from hell to heaven." And he did that through Jesus Christ, the Savior, who was born in the city of David, David who was anointed by Samuel, Samuel who was called by God, and he said, "Speak, Lord, for your servant hears." When Jesus died on the cross, he changed the direction of everything. He said, "All of your sins and bad things are now all forgiven and paid for. God is not angry with your sins." But then 3 days later, when he rose from the dead, now he said, "Follow me. I know the way to heaven." And so the Christian does. We put our trust in Jesus Christ and him alone, and we follow his direction in life. No matter where God takes us, we listen to him. Your Sunday school teachers will have a little bit more on this, and I can't wait to see you back in church. You have a great day with Jesus, your direction changer.